Students, we are now going to do a osteology class on occipital bone.
Occipital bone is a curved plate of bone which forms the posterior and lower part of the vault of the skull and base of the skull. Parts of the occipital bone. The bone is divided into three parts. That is an expanded plate of squamous part, which is curving backwards and upwards. Basilar part, which is projecting upwards and forwards. And a pair of condyles or condylar part, which are lateral to the foramen magnum. Anatomical position, keeping the foramen magnum in horizontal plane and the basilar part directed upwards and forwards. Now, description of each part. The squamous part or the squama, it has two surfaces, an internal surface and an external surface, four borders, two superolateral borders, also called as the lambdoid borders, and two inferolateral borders called as the mastoid borders, and three angles, that is one superior angle and two lateral angles. The external surface. The external surface is convex and has a median elevation called as the external occipital protuberance. This protuberance has a highest has a prominent point called as enion. This is the enion. The superior nuchal lines extend laterally from the external occipital protuberance, which are convex upwards. To this superior nuchal lines, to the entire extent, the investing layer of the deep cervical fascia is attached. The medial part of this line gives attachment to trapezius muscle, and the lateral part of this line gives insertion to the sternocleidomastoid above and splenius capitis below. So this line is a boundary between the scalp and the neck. A pair of two more curved lines arch upwards and laterally from the external occipital protuberance. They are above the superior nuchal lines. This highest nuchal lines give attachment to the galea aponeurotica medially and occipital belly of occipitofrontalis laterally. A median ridge extends downwards from the external occipital crest to the foramen magnum, and it's called as the external occipital crest. To this, the ligamentum nuchae is attached. Below the superior nuchal lines, two more curved lines arch laterally and they're called as the inferior nuchal lines. These inferior nuchal lines start start at the center of a line joining the external occipital protuberance and the posterior margin of foramen magnum in the midline. So these are the inferior nuchal lines. The area between the superior and inferior nuchal lines gives insertion to semispinalis capitis medially and obliquus capitis superior laterally. The area between the inferior nuchal lines and the foramen magnum receives insertion of rectus capitis posterior minor medially and rectus capitis posterior major laterally. The posterior margin of foramen magnum gives attachment to the posterior atlanto-occipital membrane. On this diagram, we are seeing the external occipital protuberance, external occipital crest, the highest nuchal lines, superior nuchal line, inferior nuchal lines. Attachments: highest nuchal lines medially to galea aponeurotica, laterally to occipital frontalis. Superior nuchal line, entire line to attachment of investing layer of the deep cervical fascia. Its medial part of superior nuchal line, origin of trapezius, lateral part to insertion of sternocleidomastoid above and splenius capitis below. Area between superior and inferior nuchal line. This is insertion of semispinalis capitis medially and obliquus capitis superior laterally. Area between the inferior nuchal line and the foramen magnum receives insertion of rectus capitis posterior minor medially and rectus capitis posterior major laterally.